Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the shop. For, I don't know how many minutes this goes. All right, guys. Done painting. I am done painting. I am weathering wet. Spit this out. I am ready to start the weathering process. Okay, I got my yellow stripes on there. Got the good HD video camera out. This should be the true colors right here. Got me some metal, flat metal in there. Gonna weather it all up now. Someone looked up that name. I guess that was a pretty famous dude right there. Ended up being a general. Okay, got the yellow on the tail. That looks good. That really stands it off. Snakes look good. Everything came out really good. I am really, really happy with all these letterings. Not one little smudge, smear, anything on anything. But I've had it out in the trailer all day, and it was a hot day today. And speed up the curing process, but my battery's about dead on my camera. So I had to plug it in. Now I just unplugged it. Alright, we're good now. Alright, I'm ready to start the weathering process. You guys just gonna have to sit back and watch. I've been kind of nervous about this.
I've never tried this. But Ollie's buddy, Phil, uses ink. Barry seemed to have pretty good results just using acrylic, and I heard other people using it. And that's all I'm gonna use. Okay. What I got here is just some cheapo acrylic paints. I've got some black. I got some dirt color, and I got some other dirt color. Alright. What I did, I'm just going to put them together in a little dish here. Alright. And that little bit is going to go a long ways. Alright. So I got me a little jug of water down there. Let me get this in there and get it wet. Now I want to start with my other colors first. Then get me a little tan on there, a little dirt, and a little dirt. Alright? And we're going to rub it on here. And we don't want this to be real dominant. We just want something on there besides black. You know? I'm gonna just streak it up a little bit. On the nose too. It should show up on that black. I'm putting these colors on first because I don't want nothing covering up my black that I put in the panel lines. Alright? And now you can kind of see it's just kind of streaking it up a little bit. Kind of looks like I just wet sanded it. On after it's black. Well, I figure it's like this, I'd rather underdo it a little bit. Jolly already, you know, that way if he wants to do it a little more, it could be done.
but it's hard to undo. You know, it's harder to undo than it is to do some more, you know. Beautiful. Okay, I'm going to keep this paper towel separate. Now I'm going to go to some black. So I think what I'm going to have to do is go back with them colors real light. I need to get this black pretty good to get it in all them panel lines. Come back in here later with the airbrush. Do a little more around the gun and stuff. Watching. Get your own client messing this up. Well, it's all good. You could go over this with alcohol and it'll clean it up after it's dried. I've been doing some little testing today. So if you get something you don't like, all these
apologized to me about these vents a couple times. I mean, they just don't stand out very good. You know? Once you get in here and wash it, that's a black goo. Get my paper towel wet. Doing the streak and saying that the fingers. There we go. There we go, baby. Excess with some sandpaper. Now, we're going to try wetting it a little bit first. I think it was just so dry and sucked it all in a little deep. Now, that's a better. Thank you. brush all this a little bit heavier. Now we're just trying to make it look dirty. Put some streaks in it. You guys watching that? Crazy.